to say what needs to be said. I want to thank WrestleZone for giving me the opportunity to do this, providing this production crew. Thank you. Because WrestleZone, I owe an apology to, I owe an explanation to, as well as everyone who was there at Aberdeen Anarchy, all the WrestleZone fans, all the WrestleZone staff, all the wrestlers, and especially the men that I stood alongside at Aberdeen Anarchy, Damien, Scotty Swift, and my longtime friend, William Sterling. I owe an apology and an explanation as much as I can find one to give. I didn't want it to be this way. I wanted so hard to believe in Sterling Oil. All I've ever known here in WrestleZone is Sterling Oil, and Richard R. Russell is part of that. All I wanted so badly for us to be back and for it to be like old times. We had people who needed to be taken down a peg, to be put in their place, and WrestleZone were telling us we were the ones to do it. The people were on our side for once. Everything was aligned. It was going to be perfect. We wore the colors. The music played, and it didn't feel the same. And I wanted it to so badly. But at the end of the day, the foundation of the future were just maybe a step too far. Aberdeen Anarchy that night, the foundation of the future were more Sterling Oil than Sterling Oil were. You were three individuals with a common goal, but they were a unit. From the very off, they go straight for your knee, William. Your known weakness. And they take you out of that match. You couldn't put weight on that leg. I'm trying to get people to come and help you, and no one's listening to me. I needed them to listen. They take out Scotty Swift with sheer brute force. They incapacitate Damien by outthinking him. That's smart. What wasn't smart was what you tried to do. That wasn't the William Sterling I've known for a very long time. You tried to go into a fight one against three on only one leg. What were you thinking? That's not the Sterling Oil way. What she should have done was stop, regroup, come back and live to fight another day. But you wanted to keep going. And the foundation of the future would have ended your career right there and right then in that instant. If it hadn't been for the intervention, uninvited, unannounced, unbeknownst to all of us, of Crusher Crabe. He went through one, he went through two, he went through three. He laid out the foundation of the future. I dragged you on top. One, two, not three. They didn't let Crusher stay. You were left one on three still, on one leg. What can I do? I'm not a fighter. But you want to keep going. What at that point, it was done. It was finished. We could win the match, yes, but we couldn't win the fight. You think you getting a pinfall at that point or a submission or whatever was going to stop the foundation of the future? No, you're smarter than this. You know how Sterling Oil used to do things. It's now how the foundation of the future apparently do things. And you could say at that point, I was thinking clearly for the first time in a long, long time. I had a moment. I had an epiphany, you could call it. I realized what had to happen. Sterling Oil had to die. And if you weren't going to let things go, William, then I had to. I had to. We need to move away from this. And anyone who was there at Aberdeen Anarchy saw how it affected me, how I broke down emotionally. But that wasn't just with the pain and the rage and the anger over what I had had to do to one of my best friends. It was also because it was a moment of release. I realized for the first time, I was no longer a man trapped inside a memory. I was free. Free of the shackles of Sterling Oil, free to have a future for myself. My only hope at this point, I know, I've heard what Scotty Swift has had to say. I know he is going to be gunning for an extra fight. And I just hope that he's not gunning my way. And I know that Damien was riled up, and I hope he's not gunning my way. The only thing I want right now, William Sterling, I am talking to you. I'm talking to my friend Bill right here. I hope that you can come to understand, that you can come to terms with what happened. You can agree with me that what I did was the right thing to do. And that one time, hopefully soon, you and I can stand side by side once again, and we can both agree that the best thing for everyone was that Sterling Oil ended.
Where is he? I'm not even wearing a watch. Where is he?
I'm here. Mr. Patterson.
Hello, Caleb.
You're Mr. Patterson.
No, it's James.
James, oh, well, James, I have a beer, thank you, sir.
No, I'm not a waiter. James Chesser from Coventry.
James Chesser? James Chesser! How are you, friend?
I'm the waiter just here.
You'll get your way. Two beers! Wherever you've gone.
It's okay, he's got my order, Caleb. Why am I here? Why are we all here?
Well, as you know, the mighty Caleb at Aberdeen Anarchy was triumphant when England won the championship.
Hard-fought battle?
Yes! Yes, my good friend, Lost Boy Aspen. And as we know, they also retained this beautiful Tri-Counties Championship. A championship that really helped the mighty Caleb elevate himself on to becoming the undisputed champion. A championship held by many greats, Lost Boy Aspen himself, Zach Dynamite, Mickey Vago, countless others. A championship that's really helped many elevate. And I think it's time it gave someone else a chance to do the same.
Well, are you saying what I think you're saying, Caleb?
The mighty Caleb is going to relinquish this great belt and offer someone else an opportunity to rise up. For you, sir. Make sure Mr. Patterson gets that.
Okay, no problem. Absolutely.
And you! I'll see you at Battle of the Nations, my friend, okay?
Absolutely.
Until then!
Until then.
Look after that for me.
Oh, I'm to look after. Are you sure you don't want to hand over to
me? No. I've got lots of things to do. I've got lots of reveling and scholing to do, sir. Until then! See you later!
Bye, Caleb.
Scholl!
I'll take your belt.
My belt?
No,
Mr. Patterson's belt. What am I doing?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, WrestleZone would like to welcome you to tonight's live event. Before we begin, please be advised that all WrestleZone stars are professionally trained, so please do not copy or imitate anything you see here tonight. Please also be aware that WrestleZone is proud to provide entertainment suitable for all ages, and we ask that you refrain from using any inappropriate language this evening.
Wrestling fans, it's Mr. Patterson from WrestleZone Management, and I'm standing outside the WrestleZone Training Academy, where we've turned many average Joes into WrestleZone superstars. And I have some exciting news with regards to Battle of the Nations on August 10th at the Danestone Community Centre. As we all know, Caleb Valhalla has decided to vacate the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship. So WrestleZone Management, we have decided to now have a tournament to decide who will be the next WrestleZone Tri-Counties champion. The quarterfinals for the tournament will take place at Battle of the Nations this August 10th at Danestone Community Centre. I'm looking forward to seeing you all there, and I'm sure you're looking forward to seeing the quarterfinals of the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship Tournament. Thank you.
Hello and welcome to the latest edition of the WrestleZone podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. A little bit of a pared back background here. I've taken away the background image so you can see my ears again. If you listen to the audio, of course, you couldn't ever see my ears, but I'll let you know, they are quite big. So I've just kind of pared back a little bit. We're working on possibly just sorting the background and that of future episodes. So in the meantime, that's our WrestleZone contingent is a WrestleZone t-shirt. There we go. My name is Billy. If you haven't already known that, if you don't already know that, I'm quite the fan of WrestleZone. And just giving you a little bit of a background, because we're kind of into a new season of WrestleZone. As Aberdeen Anarchy has been and gone, we're coming back for Battle of the Nations taking place this Saturday, August 10th at Danestone Community Centre in Aberdeen. Book Tesco next door if you're so inclined. I'm very excited for this one. We're on the road to next year's Aberdeen Anarchy. As I said, reset, new season, things changed at Aberdeen Anarchy and new champions were crowned. Big moments arrived. You go check the recap and check our previous SWN podcast road trip episode about Aberdeen Anarchy for a little bit more information. I want to keep you as informed as possible about WrestleZone. We try to do that through swnscotland.com, our website. We also try to do it through this podcast, the WrestleZone podcast, where I sit here in my office and talk about WrestleZone for an inordinate amount of time. So, like I said, just do a little bit of a reset for the audience, for those that are listening to this for the first time. I'm going to tell you all you need to know about this Saturday's Battle of the Nations event in Aberdeen. Those that are coming back that have been listening to the WrestleZone podcast, listen to all our podcasts, mainly me speak about WrestleZone incessantly. I'm also going to let you know that my blind is open. There's a window open as well, because every time I start recording this episode, I keep sneezing because of just dust. And I do dust this room. It's just dust has appeared. And also, the light is hitting my face at a very unfortunate angle where I look like an egg. So, for those that are listening to the audio, you are avoiding all of that. But if you're watching the video, you're seeing all of it. So, I apologize in advance. We're going to talk about all the matches that have been announced for Battle of the Nations, all the things that have been announced as well. We'll bring back a little bit of content information from Aberdeen Anarchy as well. And it's just, we're just going to have a good time. I'm going to sit here and tell you all about Battle of the Nations taking place on Saturday at Danestone Community Centre, a fantastic venue for WrestleZone, fantastic venue for wrestling as well. There's not a bad seat in the house. You can see just about everything. It's a very big hall. So let's just get into it. We've got a tournament coming up for the Tri-Couch Championship. You heard Mr. P right at the start there. We've got lots of video content to splice to, a lot of promos and just information that I'm going to throw at you for the next wee while. But in the meantime, let's just get into it. It's WrestleZone Battle of the Nations. Let's do it to it. Not even 3 minutes in, I'm stealing from OSW Review, but if you're going to steal, steal from the best. We're going to talk about WrestleZone Battle of the Nations. There's lots happening on this show that's been announced, not just from the matches. There's now 6 matches on the main show, 1 match on the VIP pre-show, 4 of which are title tournament matches, and 2 more title matches just to wet your whistle, along with a massive 6-man tag, which I no doubt will take place across Danestone Community Centre, possibly outside, possibly backstage. We don't know. I'm not looking into the future. So we're going to talk about all of that in a moment. I'll give you all the rundown, the SCA, on how to get tickets. If you can, they are limited. I think as of recording, we're recording on the 5th of August. So that will explain if any promos and that are missing, and information's missing, or if I just rambled incoherently and then something's been announced on Tuesday. And I'm sitting there going, I made a totally different point about that. That's very awkward. But you can find it, I think there was 18 tickets were left available. I've got my ticket. Kelly's got her ticket. For those that are coming back for the first, or are here for the first time, that's my wife. We've got our tickets for the show. It's her first show since the Rumble. So she's very excited for that. I'm very excited because I go get to see wrestling, which, you know, always makes me excited about the wrestling. So, Battle of the Nations event taking place Saturday, August 10th at Danestone Community Centre in Aberdeen. Tickets are still available, but limited, at ringsideworld.co.uk. Go and get your ticket. You get it instantly. Go straight to your email. It's a PDF. You can stick it in your Google Drive. You can stick it on your wallet, on your iPhone or Android. I don't know how Android works. I don't have one, but I'm assuming that's how it works. Doors open 6 p.m. for VIP, 6:30 for general. Bell time 6:15 for VIP, 7 p.m. for general. It's not a maze to get to the hall. You literally queue up, you go in, turn left, and then you go through a door, you turn right, and the ring's there. It's a very big venue, high ceiling as well, so you get a full-size ring, and there's merch right in the back corner. There's opportunities to meet the wrestlers. Don't usually before the show, sometimes there is before the show, but generally you'll get to meet some at the interval and at the end perhaps as well. So a lot of things. I'm treating this episode like it's an absolute reset on the WrestleZone podcast. Is it season 2? Will we call it a season 2? Probably not. Because I'm going to do a lot of previews this year. I'm going to miss a couple shows as well. for other reasons. So there'll be a lot of preview heavy events and shows on this podcast network for the WrestleZone podcast, certainly. But let's just, I'm rambling. This is not a good sign. This is a rambly episode of the WrestleZone podcast. I'm going to do my absolute best to try and get some points across so you know what's happening and I can keep you abreast of information for WrestleZone Battle of the Nation. So yeah, ringsideworld.co.uk, go get your tickets. There are limited, but 18 left. There'll be probably less than 10 by the time this episode goes out. It's going to be full. It's an absolute bustling atmosphere at the Danestone Community Centre, a venue that's been used a lot by WrestleZone over the years for some huge events, including Aberdeen in 2023, which was fantastic as well. So plenty, less time, not a lot of time. If you haven't got your ticket already, go get your ticket in Aberdeen, Danestone. I think there's sure as bus routes. Go on social media, WrestleZone Scotland, they will keep you right as well. Or go to Google, you know. Anyway, let's go talk about the title tournament. Let's kick that off with the VIP ticket holder match. I am warm, sweaty, and excited, and that's just because of the weather. It is so close. I'm roasting. I mean, the window's open, but it makes no difference. The VIP ticket holder match. Right, before we get to that match exactly, there's going to be a lot of talk about the WrestleZone Tri-Counties tournament taking place, kicking off the quarterfinals this weekend on Saturday, August 10th. So, recap. WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy taking place a couple months ago, May. I'm panicked because I've started that sentence. I don't have the information to hand. May. We'll say May. WrestleZone with the main event. Tri-Counties champion Caleb Valhalla taking on the undisputed WrestleZone champion Lost Boy Aspen. Winner takes all. And Caleb won and took all. So he became Tri-Counties champion, which he retained, and became the new undisputed WrestleZone champion. So I'm going to put a video somewhere, probably before this, that Caleb Valhalla opted, while speaking to James Chesser, to vacate the Tri-Counties championship. He is no longer the Tri-Counties champion. He vacated that belt. And Mr. P has decided, along with WrestleZone management, that the new champion will be decided in a WrestleZone Tri-Counties tournament, of which, by my reckoning, the winner will be announced or confirmed. It might be Halloween hijinks, but more likely going to be Christmas chaos. I can't remember offhand. I will find out that information by the recap, because I'm sure more information will be given between now and then. So that's it. We've got 8 competitors going for this title, one of which is a former champion, one of which is a former Tri-Counties champion, is a former Undisputed champion in there as well. There's a lot going on. But the first one that I can talk about right now is the VIP ticket holder match. So those that have paid a little bit extra for a VIP ticket, you get in a little bit earlier. Doors open at 6, first bell 6:15. You get to see this match, and a match I am super excited for, even though there is a little bit of Stockholm Syndrome involved because Judas Grey keeps throwing things at me at shows. It doesn't, not just WrestleZone, Discovery Wrestling threw stuff at me as well. So wherever I go and Judas is there, just know I'm getting something thrown at me. So Judas Grey will be taking on Tommy Raiden in the first quarterfinal match on the VIP ticket holder section of Battle of the Nations. And this is a match that's got a lot of story behind it. It's not just a case of these two guys wrestling. That's not it. When Judas Grey came into WrestleZone, he came in at Christmas Chaos last year. He came in a match with Mickey Vago. Mickey Vago was accompanied by his new student. Is that what we went with? Mentee? Tommy Raiden. Tommy Raiden was his mentee. Vago was his mentor. Go with that. That's it. I'll make sense of it eventually. So Judas Grey lost to Mickey Vago thanks to Tommy Raiden. So Tommy Raiden got interfered. He got pretty much Judas made Tommy Raiden just so angered and annoyed that he took that into his own hands to assist Mickey Vago. And you know what? The fans enjoyed it. The fans cheered for it. But Judas Grey took exception to that. And fair enough, he took exception to that. I wouldn't really want to be... I wouldn't take that. I spent that whole time wrestling someone, but then having someone on the ringside, who, you know, they're not supposed to get involved in matches. They're not supposed to get involved. They're supposed to be there to support Mickey Vago. Here I am defending Judas Grey because he has a point, you know? So months passed. Regal Rumble rolls round. A tag team match. We've got Speed Metal against Wally's. So it's Tommy Raiden and Mickey Vega's Speed Metal taking on Rhys Dawkins and Brian Tucker. And look who appeared. Judas Grey made his return to WrestleZone to distract Mickey Vega, but not touch Mickey Vega. There was no altercation involved. It was simply Judas Grey caused a distraction long enough for Tommy Raiden to get cracked in the skull with a book of Shakespeare to cost them the match. There was a measure of revenge for both in that moment, in that event, with Mickey Vega eliminating Judas Grey from the Regal Rumble itself. But this still lingers, this Judas Grey Tommy Raiden situation. Came right to Aberdeen Anarchy, we got the six-man tag team match, Gangrel and Speed Metal taking on the combined team of Rhys Dawkins, Brian Tucker and Judas Grey, where Gangrel, Tommy Raiden and Mickey Vega did pick up the win on that occasion. So that's where we're up to in the story of Mickey Vega, Judas Grey, Tommy Raiden, everyone being involved in this particular feud and altercation, that's not the word, but you know what I mean, convince. I'm just making up words there. So this quarterfinal match, Judas Grey, Tommy Raiden. This has got a lot of heated backstory, a lot of heated stuff behind it. This is not just a simple match on the pre-show or the VIP ticket holder section. The winner, of course, will move on to the semi-finals in the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship Tournament. So there's a lot at stake here. It's not just a win-loss match. A win here will put them further into title contention to become the new WrestleZone Tri-Counties Champion. And, you know, these guys have both got relatively short careers at this moment in time, but Judas Grey has been everywhere at the moment. He has appeared in Discovery. He's a current Scottish Openweight Champion there. He's appeared in Ireland recently. He's appeared in England. He has travelled across the country learning things and becoming more dangerous in the ring when it comes to his in-ring moveset as well. So Judas Grey has probably got the edge here when it comes to experience in the ring. He does. That's I can't understate that. He does have more experience in the ring. He's got more matches under his belt, more high-profile matches under his belt as well. Whereas Tommy Raiden, he's still under the guidance of Mickey Vega. He did have a match out with Aberdeen very recently, outside of the Northeast recently, down in Frockenheim, I think the place was called, which is a beautiful name, if I've got that right, if I haven't butchered it at all, somewhere right about the Angus area. So he has started to venture out of the Northeast as well. But generally, Tommy Raiden's home is WrestleZone, and he's wrestled there for, what was it, I think it was October 22, I think he made his debut. So he's got a couple of years under his belt. He's come up to 2 years on live shows in front of a crowd. He's probably getting a lot of reps through the gala season, whereas Judas Grey, like I say, is traveling. He's traveling to like the Pursuit, like the Titanic. He's traveling around the country, picking up all this information. Whereas Tommy, who is picking up that information, possibly isn't as accelerant at getting that information as Judas is at the moment. So that's a very interesting concept. The other thing that's interesting is Tommy Raiden might be in this alone, because his mentor, Mickey Vega, will be in the main event. We'll talk about that in a little bit. So is he coming into this alone? Will Judas have the helping hand of the likes of Flippy and Drippy? Because Judas and Ronan King very much have a close relationship as a tag team elsewhere as Vanity. There's always that chance. We haven't seen it in WrestleZone yet, Judas Grey and Ronan King as a tandem on events, on shows. We've seen it a little bit backstage and promos and things like that. So there's that as well to consider. There's a lot to consider in this match, and I'm absolutely amazed this is on the VIP ticket holder section. So I would implore you, get a VIP ticket if you haven't already. If they're still available when this goes out on Wednesday, go get a ticket, get the VIP ticket, because you'll want to see Judas Grey versus Tommy Raiden. That is a guarantee. That is a promise. And I say all that good things about Judas Grey, all that good things about Tommy Raiden, I absolutely know Judas Grey is going to throw something at me. And you know what's even worse? I'm taking my 2-year-old son to this event, and he's going to have to watch his dad get something thrown at his face. This is going to be his first ever wrestling show, and he's going to watch his dad get assaulted by an article of clothing. Wrestling for you, that's what wrestling is all about. So that was a lot to take in. I'm very excited about this event, as you can tell. I've had a reprieve. I've had a rock star, a zero sugar watermelon kiwi. I'm on zeros because, you know, got trimmed down a little bit. So I'm all excited. Let's go talk about the main card. If you haven't already, ringsideworld.co.uk, go get a ticket if you haven't. VIP ticket, because Judas Grey versus Tommy Raiden is an absolute banger. Absolute banger of a VIP ticket holder match. Right. Let's get into the main card.
Great feeling. It's a great feeling. After being successful at Aberdeen Anarchy and regaining my hat. It looks good, isn't it? It's only fitting. Only fitting that WrestleZone would reward me with a chance at the Tri-County title. A title I've already held. I shouldn't have to even have to be in a tournament to win it. I should just be given it like I was given back my hat. However, standing in my way is Alex Webb. Alex Webb. Alex Webb. I'm not scared of spiders. I'm not scared of Spider-Man. In fact, just today, I punched 5 spiders in the face. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in Battle of the Nations, it won't be a spider. No. It'll be your friends. It'll be you, Alex Webb. It feels the wrath. The wrath of the Seamon. The wrath of Captain Alan Sterling. Because I'll leave you with my dust. My dust. As I go on to become Tri-County's champion. Because it really is all about Alan.
Even I'm getting distracted by that blind in the corner. I'm so sorry, everyone. But if I put it down, I'm just going to get really warm. And my glasses steam up as it is. So it's just, you're just going to have to put up with it. So just ignore the top left corner. You'll be all right. Or the top right. My left. Top left. Top left corner. Let's look at other matches in the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship Tournament. The 3 other quarterfinals. We're going to start off with this one. Alex Webb taking on Captain Alan Sterling. And a match that very interesting again, because Alex Webb, he's coming off a win against Air Miles Abdiarki. He is now on his own in WrestleZone, the former WrestleZone Tag Team Champion with Air Miles. He wrestled in Air Miles' final match ever. Miles has went off into retirement, into his journey has now ended in the world of professional wrestling. So Alex Webb, the other half of the Fair City Saints, is on his own. He's still rejuvenated by the power of so many subscribers on YouTube. We'll tell you how many subscribers will be backing Alex Webb, of course, right now. One of which is me, because I follow the young man. So I've suddenly went into that mode. So we're powered by the tune of 186,000 subscribers on YouTube. God, love a slice of that. Alex Webb will be coming into the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Tournament to look for his first ever singles title. I'm sure he's held a hardcore championship somewhere, a 24/7 title elsewhere, possibly at Reckless. So he's got singles gold experience, however brief. But this is his first time when, a main title. Because, you know, hardcore titles are cool. I would love to win a hardcore title. If I find the opportunity in a 24/7 environment to win a hardcore title, tonight I'd take a chance. But this is going to be his first shot at a proper singles gold, you know, the Tri-Counties Championship. He's on his own now in wrestling. I mean, he debuted on his own against Brian Tucker, someone else who's in this tournament. So he's got singles experience around the country and in wrestling specifically, but the last few years has been primarily as a tag team wrestler as Fair City Saints, where they've enjoyed success as WrestleZone Tag Team Champions, beating the Foundation of the Future to win those titles way back in this venue at Danestone Community Centre. I mean, they lost titles at Danestone Community Centre, so it's a 50-50 when it comes to the luck at this particular venue. But he's taken on Captain Alan Sterling, a former WrestleZone Tri-Counties Champion, who's actually coming off a loss at Aberdeen Anarchy. Don't believe what he's just said in that promo video, that video there, because he did not actually win. He lost the ladder match to Omar Mohamed, TV's Omar Mohamed, in that event. And Omar, he got his Shivani back, and he left Captain Allen's hat behind, which Captain Allen retrieved. So, though technically, Captain Allen lost the match, he still regained his battle hat for use for battling. I suppose that's what it's used for. So So this is the second match that we talk about, the Wrestle Strikeouts Championship Tournament quarterfinal. Alex Webb taking on Captain Al Sterling. I'm not sure if they've ever wrestled each other in wrestles. I mean, I doubt they would have wrestled elsewhere because Captain Al likes to dock in Aberdeen. He likes to stay at Aberdeen Harbour. I'm going to go find out. Because this seems how loosey-goosey this particular preview podcast is going to be, where I'm just going to talk forever, it seems. So let's go look at the wonderful world of cage match and see if we've ever had Captain Al Sterling against Alex Webb. And we have not. If they have come across each other, it would have been in a Regal Rumble, perhaps. So we've never actually had this one-on-one match, Alex Webb versus Captain Al. I'm excited for this, you know? Because Captain Allen, former Tri-County champion, former multi-time tag team champion, he's a dangerous individual in the ring, but he's also a bit of a buffoon. So I think Alex Webb will need to kind of ascertain how much shenanigans he will be able to put up with, and maybe even think about, because there's a lot of pressure on Alex Webb going into this, because he's now classed as a singles wrestler. He's not classed as a tag team wrestler doing singles matches. He's now a singles wrestler doing singles matches. And a couple of years doing tag team stuff, that can change your total mindset as a wrestler, I assume. Never been wrestled a moment in my life. But I assume that would change your mentality, because you're not looking for a tag now. You can't look for a tag all the time, because you're a singles wrestler now. You're going for singles gold in this championship tournament. So we've got that to consider for Alex Webb. Confidence is never short. When it comes to Webby, he likes to surface level some confidence, and that might be what he definitely need it, because Captain Allen, he's got a habit of breaking down even the best of them just with his tomfoolery and chicanery. So Alex Webb's really going to have to keep that in mind as well. But this will be a new reset. Talking about reset in this podcast, we're talking about just making it brand new. Alex Webb's going to have to try and reset himself as a wrestler to combat these new challenges that he'll have. Captain Allen is a former multi-time tag team champion with his brother William. He is, even though he may present himself as a bit of an idiot, he is a very accomplished wrestler in WrestleZone in the Northeast. So that's got to be kept in mind every time. There was a period where Captain Allen went near undefeated for a year very recently in WrestleZone. So, you know, you can't underestimate him. Like I say, he comes out with the t-shirt that has his faces all over it. He wears a battle cap. He wears the sailor's hat. He does all these silly things. But he's still a multi-time champion in WrestleZone and a very accomplished champion, like I said. So, yeah, this will be an interesting one. I'm looking forward to it. Looking forward to seeing how this goes. This is going to be a good bit of fun in the Northeast. Fun for us to watch. Maybe not so fun for Alex Webb if he's going to have to try and weave through the absolute I've used a lot of verbs already. Verbs? Yeah, I think verbs is the correct use of word there to describe Captain Allen, but we'll see how it goes. Captain Allen will be coming in with a lot of semen, and Alex Webb will be coming in with the power of 186,000 YouTube followers and the fans in attendance as well. So this is going to be a good one. I'm looking forward to it.
So Battle Nations, August 10th, Danestone Community Centre, Tri-County Tournament.
It's me against Brian Tucker, a man I've beat before, a man I'm confident I can beat again. But you, sir, you have Rhys Dawkins.
I do, the most intelligent wrestler on this side of the globe. But is that proven, IQ? Let's not underestimate them, because if things go well in this tournament, we get to the finals. We could get a match that never happened.
That match, that friendly competition, that one-on-one
exactly.
For the championship.
Let's get all the way.
Every man for himself.
Stop. What's going on here?
Nations, we've got the tournament coming up.
Everything you do gets run by me, remember. You're under my tutelage. You do what I tell you to do. Now, I'm not at Battle of Nations, so this Tri-County's title tournament, regardless of which one of you wins, the gold comes back. To me.
Hold on, no, that's not how this works.
Yes, I know exactly how this works.
Right, guys, come on, let's just
get back. Now, I got these because I want you both to remember one thing. You represent me.
No, I'm winning this tournament for me, not for you.
It's not
okay. Holy, you can't just... You can't be serious.
Why are you doing
this? Hey, I've not got time to sort this out. You get after him and make sure he puts that thing on.
I'll sort it.
Get it sorted now! And then get back here, so there's stuff for you to do.
Now, we'll kind of do the last two Tri-Counties Championship quarterfinals together. We'll break it up with the graphic in between, but there's something interesting about this that I've just pulled up. I've pulled out the match brackets, the tournament brackets for this. So, the Tri-Counties Championship Tournament quarterfinal, we've got Evan Young taking on Brian Tucker in the first match of my preview of these two matches here, for good reason. You'll find out why. You've just watched Evan Young and Oliver Green speak to Chris Archer. I'll put it somewhere that more explains why I've lumped these two matches together. Evan Young taking on Brian Tucker. So Evan and Brian, they've got a little bit of history in that Evan defeated Brian Tucker at Aberdeen Anarchy way back in 2022. Yeah, that was the first one back after the pandemic. So there's a little bit of history there when it comes to WrestleZone and their history. Brian Tucker is a former Undisputed Champion. He's a former Tag Team Champion. He, again, much like Captain Alan Sterling, very accomplished as a wrestler in the Northeast. Acting a bit of a Wally at the moment, you know, with the Gallises and the Tartan. And I'm still waiting for that vlog on Vimeo or wherever he was going to put it on. I'll never forget Brian. So Brian takes on Evan. Evan, who came off a loss at Aberdeen Anarchy. He lost to Chris Archer in the pre-show in the VIP match there. So now he is under the guidance, kicking and screaming, under the guidance of Chris Archer, who will not be in attendance at this event. He will leave Evan to stick to the status quo and go out on his own in this match. But no doubts he will be blowing up his phone, his DMs, making sure that Young takes on all the advice that Chris Archer has to give for his wards to become the new Tri-Counties champion. Brian Tucker, like I say, he's a bit of a mad cat, but he's definitely got the accomplishments behind him in the past, and he can be vicious, even though he's coming off a loss at Ariarchy as well. He was in that six man, as mentioned, with Gangrel, Speed Metal, Rhys Dawkins, and Judas Grey. He's got the championship pedigree in the Northeast to get it done. He was in the final four-way to crown the very first Tri-Counties champion. That was a tournament as well. Ended up being in a four-way ladder match that Lost Boy Aspen ended up winning. So he knows how to get to the final of his tournament. He knows how to make his way through this kind of terrain. And he could very well do it. He could very well make it all the way and into the finals and become Grand Slam champion in WrestleZone. That's the only thing he's missing, is the Tri-Counties Championship. He's been Undisputed Champion. He's won the Regal Rumble. He's been Tag Team Champion. He is missing the Tri-Counties Championship from that accolade, from that Grand Slam possibility and Triple Crown as well, to mark only the second time someone has accomplished that feat in the modern day for WrestleZone. So that's a lot on the line for Brian Tucker. Whether he is able to take that all in, that's another matter entirely. But let's look at the other half of this.
Boy, it's great to be back in the training academy. Rhys Dawkins! Right, how are you doing?
Right, yourself? Where have you been?
Been on my holidays. It's the summer season.
That's true.
I have been on my holidays.
Where did you go?
We are massive. Timbuktu.
It's cold in summer.
Well, I got tan somehow.
But Brian, I've been preparing. We've got the Tri-Counties Championship Tournament at Battle of the Nations on August 10th.
The what? This is news?
Caleb Valhalla vacated the Tri-Counties Championship, and they're making a tournament for it, and you and I are in the first round.
Me and you?
First round? No, sorry. You are facing Evan Young, and I am facing Oliver Green, Archer's Quiver, in the first round.
Oh, this is good. You know what? I have a bone to pick with that Evan Young. He beat me at Aberdeen Anarchy a few years ago, and I've never gotten over it.
Now we can get our chance. And the Tri-Counties Championship is on the line. It's a huge opportunity, especially for me. I've not won a championship in WrestleZone, and we've not had the best luck over the last couple of years. But now our fortunes will change. And when we meet each other in the final round, it'll be a battle of champions, battle of gentlemen, and the winner
The best man win. We still get the best man will win.
Okay. I'm just, you know, just been lifting weights. Arm day.
You do it. Get those racks in. Get them in.
Once more onto the breach, dear friends.
So the other half of this is Oliver Green taking on Rhys Dawkins. So this is two guys that made their debuts very recently. That could be in the last 2 years. The last 2 years of WrestleZone. Rhys Dawkins, who came in with his first match, was a first win against Blue Thunder way back in 2022 at Aberdeen Anarchy. And he's kind of fallen into the crowd with Brian Tucker, and it's dragged him down a little bit, just a little bit. But Oliver Green has been dragged into the issues with Evan Young and Chris Archer, and now he is also under the guidance of Chris Archer. Now, I've said now quite a few times, this is where the interest lies. You're going to hear somewhere in the surrounding of these two matches, Brian Tucker and Rhys Dawkins talking about meeting each other in the final. We have the brackets for this. I'm going to show it now. And if you look at that, there's an issue with this. So the brackets, as you can see, we've got Tom and Aiden taking on Judas Gray. The semi-final will be the winner of Alex Webb versus Captain Allen. You know? Cool. We've got Evan Young, and there, so we've got Evan Young, Brian Tucker in the quarterfinal, and the semi-final will be the winner between Rhys Dawkins and Oliver. So there is not a possibility. I mean, there were shenanigans in the previous WrestleZone Tri-Counties tournament that made it a four-way in the end, but I'm sure Mr. P will have found all the loopholes and closed them to not make this happen again. But there's not a way that Brian Tucker and Rhys Dawkins will meet in the final. They will meet in the semi-final if they're able to get past Evan Young and Oliver Green. So that's a little bit of an issue for Brian Tucker, possibly for Rhys Dawkins as well. But a very interesting prospect that we could possibly see Chris Archer having to stand in the middle and watch his two new young lions, Evan Young and Oliver Green, face off. I mean, they've had a few matches in the past before already. They've been in triple threats as well with each other. They're quite the VIP ticket holder match circuit kind of thing. They had a few matches in with each other as via triple threats and the like. So they've got a little bit of experience with each other in the ring together. But so Brian Tucker and Rhys Dawkins, unfortunately, may not have that final they dream of. It'll certainly be whoever the best man may win, if that's the case. I'm going to throw out predictions of this event. I think that semi-final, that left-hand bracket with Tommy Raiden, Judas Gray, Alex Webb, Captain Allen, that is a very interesting semi-final situation. I would love to see Judas Gray versus Alex Webb. You know, just, I would love to see that. I think that would be an absolutely phenomenal match. But of the combinations that you could get in this tournament, you're not going to go far wrong, I think. It's a very interesting tournament. Who's going to be the next champion? And it has seen the amount of wrestlers that have won that Tri-Counties Championship has went on to win the Undisputed Championship, lost by Aspen, Zach Dynamite as well. Possibly even Mickey Vago. We don't know how this night is going to end on August 10th. But again, we'll speak about that in a minute. I've got two more matches to talk about before I get to the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. So there's a lot at stake that not only in the immediacy of becoming WrestleZone Tri-Counties Champion, but also that gives you a little bit of gravitas, a little bit of extra weight if you're looking to become Undisputed WrestleZone Champion in the future as well. Oliver Green versus Rhys Dawkins, I'm really excited for. I really like Oliver Green. I think, as I've said numerous videos, I think he's just missing a little bit of an edge. And maybe Chris Archer will be able to do that. He may be able to cascade some knowledge onto him to become just a little bit more of an edge for future matches for going forward. And Rhys Dawkins, he's a very special talent. I think Rhys Dawkins should be in other places as well as wrestlers in the Northeast. So we'll see if he's on his own, if he hasn't got Brian Tucker with him. I think we're going to see a little bit of a masterclass from Rhys Dawkins and Oliver Green in this particular match on the show. It's going to be great. So that's your four matches for the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship Tournament. Let's look at what else is on the card. There is still a packed event that I haven't even tippled on yet. That's not even a word It's not even, well, it is a word. It's not in the good, it's not in context. But we've got a lot to get through. Let's look at the rest of the card. So we've got three matches left to go through. First up, let's look at the WrestleZone Tag Team Championship match. We've got Flippy and Drippy, Ronnie King and Connor Malloy making their first official defense of the WrestleZone Tag Team Championships, getting the rematch clause possibly out of the way for them when they take on Murphy and Ted O'Keefe of the Outfit, team that they defeated way back at Aberdeen Anarchy for the gold to become the new champions. Not without controversy. There was a title belt used. There was, I think there was a low blow as well. So the team of Ronan King and Conor Malloy, yeah, they may have got the tainted victory on the night at Aberdeen Anarchy, but these are, but that's just the referee's discretion. He called the win, he called for the bell, he made the three count. Flippy and Drippy are your WrestleZone Tag Team Champions. And they had these four had a fantastic match at Aberdeen Anarchy at the Rich Energy Arena in Aberdeen. And I'm not going to say no to a round two. You know, it was a great match. I don't know what more I can really say about this particular match itself that I didn't say way back in the Aberdeen Anarchy preview. But you know, we're resetting for season two of this podcast, so I can say maybe some of it again. But now we've got Ted O'Keefe and Murphy chasing the gold. They're not looking to maintain the gold. They're looking to gain it back. So with that bitterness for how they lost the titles at Aberdeen Anarchy, that could make them make mistakes. It could also make them hungrier to become WrestleZone Tag Team Champions again. You know what I'm going to say? I'm going to say it because it's for those that have listened to past podcasts. The Dino factor is still there. It's still alive. It was announced there was going to be a free bird rule for the WrestleZone Tag Team Championships. Dino went out injured. That free bird rule was never used because Dino was injured. He never made it back in time for the Outfit lost the titles to Flippy and Drippy. So Dino is still a factor. Is that going to be a factor in the Tag Team Championship match? Will Ted O'Keefe and Murphy come out and Ted announce that it's still operating out? You're facing the Outfit. They didn't sign who was going to be representing the Outfit. The graphic department assumed it was going to be Ted O'Keefe and Murphy, and we have Dino come out and we get Dino and Murphy against the Outfit. Is that a possibility? Am I going to go down this conspiracy theory every time until Dino comes back? Absolutely, is that's what I'm going to do. So you're just going to have to deal with it. So there's a lot of possibilities here for that to happen. But like I said, these guys had a phenomenal match at Aberdeen Anarchy. I want to see it again at Battle of Nations. I'm happy that I'm getting to see it again. I did think possibly because Flippy and Drippy called out a bunch of tag teams recently on Instagram. There's a bunch of matches that teams that they mentioned that my mouth was watering at the possibility of seeing. So if they get past the Outfits, and like I said, we're devil's avocado here. If Flippy and Drippy move past the Outfit and the Outfit have to move to the back of the line because they lost their rematch, I'm very excited to see what teams Wrestle Management will be looking to try and bring up to try and challenge Ronan King and Conor Malloy. There's a lot of teams mentioned. Quintessential was mentioned. Casino Brutal was mentioned. There are so many teams in that video. So go check out Ronan King's social media, because I think that's where it was. Maybe on Connor's. But, you know, while there's, go to Instagram, you'll find it, I'm sure. If you type in Ronan King, you'll find the video somewhere. But there was a bunch of cool names announced that I would love to see in matches. Hell, I'd like to see those teams against the Outfit. Give me Casino Brutal versus the Outfit. I'll take that. Yeah. So either way, get the Outfit up. Get Casino Brutal up. that's the point to that little bit there. It's an exciting time in the tag team division for WrestleZone. I'm looking forward to seeing. Hopefully they'll expand. We've got some teams reuniting. The Foundation of the Future have been very dominant over that division for a little while now. The Outfit came in and changed that by when they became the WrestleZone Tag Team Champions. But I'm looking forward to possibly seeing into 2024, moving into 2025, maybe some new tag teams making their way up to the Northeast for some challenges to the champions, whether it is Flippy and Drippy or the Outfit. But in our match, like I say, fantastic Aberdeen Anarchy. I can't wait to see it again.
2 days later.
We should be more upset. We should be more angry. Aberdeen Anarchy, our title belts were stolen from us from Flippy and Drippy. They knocked you in the head with the title belt, damaged your shoulder in the process. We should be furious at them, but we're not. Because when we were your age, we would have done the exact same thing. So we understand why you did it. We understand you want to be on top. But here's the thing, you didn't think about that. Because if you beat us fair and square, that was fine. You would have got to move on. But because you used dirty tactics, because you clocked my friend in the head with a title belt, that's an automatic rematch.
Yeah. It's Battle of Nations. Flippy and drippy. Yeah, as you can see, I'm almost a shoulder down. And management might not even let me compete, but I'll be there. I'll be there, even if I have to beat you one hand.
If we have to beat you both with one hand tied behind our backs, we're going to do it. Because we've got the heart, we've got the power, and the outfit are going to get back the title belts that were stolen from us.
Oh, Luke Murphy, let's be realistic here. The outfit didn't lose the belts. Murphy didn't lose. Dio didn't lose. You know who lost? Me. I was the one that turned my back and I got clocked. And who's to say it won't happen again? I'm not 100% either. Look, it's... Maybe it's just me.
Ted!
For the first time in quite some time, we are back together again in the Zoom, Mr. Muhammad, and I want to congratulate you because one person on this call tonight had a sensational Aberdeen Anarchy. Your bucket list of things that you want to do, you want to tick them off one by one, competing in a ladder match, has always been in your bucket list, and not only did you do it, but you won it. So for that, I say congratulations.
Thank you. You know, it was a tough battle. You know, I got the Shirvani back.
You did?
Captain Allen, I felt bad for him. You know, we went through hell.
Really?
We went through hell. We went through a ladder match. I had to give him back the hat. You know, I had to give him back. You know, there's a clean one there. I don't know the one that Captain Allen had. That one was a mess. But, you know, I thought I'd keep a clean one, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I'd like to have said this to you in person. But
okay.
Here's the thing. What's going on with Sterling Oil?
That
whole day, I couldn't even reach you.
I had a feeling, okay? Like, don't think I'm going out of my way to not include you in things. Don't think I'm going out of my way to ignore you. It's not, look, I showed up. I came back at the Regal Rumble. It was unannounced. As a matter of fact, you're one of the people that phoned me who told me what happened to Martin Clunas, that he was attacked by the Foundation of the Future. And because of your phone call, that got me to the building. And I didn't know it was going to end up teaming with William Sterling. I didn't know it was going to end up there being managed by Richard R. Russell. Me and Damien had issues in the past, but we've been cool for a couple of years now. But still, Sterling Oil, that's madness, okay? It's madness. But extreme circumstances call for extreme actions to take place. And Damien was giving me the side eye when I was giving Richard R. Russell the side eye. And William Sterling had us convinced that it was a done deal, nothing to worry about. It's all taken care of. And I was wrong.
Right, hold on. I'm going to have to stop you right there. No, I'm going to have to stop you right there. Okay? You're
saying
it's a done deal. I've seen the tapes. I wasn't around in 2018, 2016, 2017 when Sterling Oil was a thing. Okay? But I've seen the tapes. Sterling Oil cannot be trusted. And I could have told you that in person, but you were too busy focusing with them. And look what happened. Okay,
but,
so,
yeah,
I don't get it.
Omar, you're right. You know, you're right. For what you're saying there, it makes a lot of sense. But cards on the table, I don't know what the situation is now, Omar. I don't. This was never a slight on you. I could have never predicted this would ever happen. I don't feel I'm done. Okay? William Sterling's out the picture. His knee's a mess, and I can't rely on him to be back in action. Damien hasn't spoke to me since the end of Aberdeen Anarchy, and if you heard what he was saying under his breath after the match, you'd understand why. Now, I can't go against these guys alone, and I'm not asking for your help, but I've got a suspicion that it's something that's been on your mind for a long time because you've had your problems with the Foundation as well. So I'm just saying, You know.
Oh man, you're good. You're really good, aren't you?
Hey, what is that meant to mean? Right.
So, obviously, I understandably did have my own thing with Captain Allen. I got the Shirani back. That was the whole thing.
Yeah.
But I'm not over what happened with the Foundation and myself. Okay?
I know. I feel it. I know. I am aware.
The Captain Allen thing, that was a little thing that happened, but the focus hasn't changed. I still want the Foundation.
Okay.
But if it's me and you, okay, if it's me and you, that's still 3v2. So, Damien's not out the picture. I wouldn't say so. If he's still somewhat there, we just need to get to him.
I'm going
to
need your help, though. Because the team that never happened, the team that always was, the team that was killed by COVID in the Regal Rumble 2022, though we unofficially dubbed the Turbo Team, but... I know things are a lot more serious now. Look, I believe between myself and your good self, we could probably talk Damien round. Now, I can go now. I can lay the groundwork. But we got gala season. You love a gala, yeah, right? If you can get yourself here in the Granite City, if we can get Damien with us in person and plead the case, because... as far as I'm concerned, and I know the Foundation, they think they're done with this. I'm not done.
No.
I've had too much sleepless nights since I ran Anarchy to walk away from this. And I need you, man. I need you. What'd you say? We're doing this. We're going to try and make this happen. We're going to try and make this work.
Yeah, screw it. I'm in.
I love it.
Let's get Damien.
I still have my Sherwinnie over there, man. It's just, all I need is break glass in case of emergency, and that bad boy comes back out again. That's all I'm saying, yeah?
Listen, you say that you've not worn that Shirani in a while. See the Shirani that, I wore the night you retired?
Mm-hmm.
I've never worn that again. So it's time to break that one out again as well. How about that?
Well, I like that. Right, on that note, I'm going to love you and leave you. I'll be in touch. Okay?
Right.
I'll be in touch.
I have anything to do with it.
Did you have Richard R. Russell?
Look, I had nothing to do with Richard R. Russell. He admitted as much himself, right? And now you've heard it from me. Do you really think I would hide something like that from my brothers? No. Of course not.
No, you're right. Yeah, Anarchy. Foundation of the Future, Bruiser Brad, Zach Dynamite, Ryan Riley. We put an end to Sterling Oil.
We killed it.
I got put through a table. We were attacked with chairs. But we were all standing at the end, victorious. And it doesn't matter if Crusher Crabe came back. It doesn't matter if Richard R. Russell did what he did to William Sterling. We three here were standing tall at the end.
Scotty! Scotty, if you come at me, if I see you again, this time, I'm going to break your neck. Because of Aberdeen Anarchy, I just hurt you. I just hurt you. But next time I see you, I'm going to break it.
So Scott, Omar, do yourselves a favor. We're giving you an out. Don't come chasing the Foundation. Because if you do, we will do to you boys what we do to you will make what we did to Sterling Oil look like child's play.
He's on Facebook.
I knew I couldn't hide from you guys forever.
Whoa. Look. I just need 2 minutes.
Ah.
I need a minute from you.
On you go.
Look.
This was going to happen anyway.
I'm still wearing this hoodie because, quite frankly, I'm not over it. Physically,
how's your neck?
Just about bad.
Come on.
In bits. Awful.
Yeah.
I feel terrible. Yeah. Birthday party, new regala, old Meldrum Highland Games. Still persevering. Shouldn't have done it. I'm an idiot. But I love WrestleZone. Unlike the guys that we were up against at Anarchy. And now you know for a fact.
You know for certainty
that we're not done, right? So whatever your issues are, deal with them. so we can finish what we started, what we should have finished at Aberdeen Anarchy.
I understand what you're saying, but what you're, for me, what you're saying is you're not done. Yeah?
I'm not done.
I spent years wasting my time, wasting my energy, my blood, my sweat, my tears on Sterling Oil and on Richard R. Russell. And it got me nowhere. Now you think that I'm going to spend the latter portion of my WrestleZone career, a company that I love too, Scott. You think that I'm going to spend it trying to take down this cockroach that won't die? Forget it. I'm done. I don't know if you noticed, Aspen Faith lost his championship.
I know.
That means I can challenge now.
I get it. All due respect, no? Taking all that on board, get over it.
Get over it.
Because you know Damien is a guy that doesn't start back down from a fight. Damien's a guy who's done everything. Well. Damien's like me, who's been here since day one, and WrestleZone runs through your veins, and we've got Foundation in the Future trying to tear the whole thing down, and you're saying,
right.
You're done!
Love the sound of your voice.
I'm telling you!
You tell me to get
I'm
over
telling
it.
You!
You're the one that's dragging him!
Listen!
Okay? I asked to be a part of this. He didn't want me a part of that. I asked to be a part of this. I've had my issues with the Foundation of the Future beforehand as well, okay? Don't forget what happened at Christmas Chaos. And he's right. We can't do this with just us two.
No.
We need three.
Yeah.
Okay? And listen, we need you. So whatever is going on in this mind of yours, snap out of it and get your stuff together.
We can't do this without you.
Damn it!
Can't be done.
I've waited long enough. I've waited long enough as well, yeah.
We are getting nothing. Radio silence from Damien. But that doesn't mean that we're done. I can't accept the fact that we just walk away and let the Foundation of the Future do whatever they want to do without those consequences that I keep talking about. So we've been speaking. We've been mulling it over. Yeah. If it needs to be 2-on-2, we'll do 2-on-2. If it needs to be...
Well, a 2-on-2 sounds a bit underwhelming, doesn't it?
So, you just... Are you talking to us now?
I guess so. I took a bit of time, like you told me to do. I took a bit of time to myself. I cleared my head.
Okay.
And instead of this being a 2-on-2...
Right.
Russell! It took me a long time. But I watched that promo. I watched you sit down. I watched you feel sorry for yourself. Throw yourself a little pity party. I watched you say that you owed us an apology, but didn't apologise. At Battle of the Nations, if you're down and you're down, we make this 3-on-3. We're putting out the challenge right now. Are you boys, whether you're in line with Russell or not, going to accept?
Did you see it? Did you really see it? Did you hear the words that were coming out of those idiots' mouths? A challenge! Of course we accept, you absolute idiots! We are the best three-man team in all of Scotland! And we are even more laser-focused now than we ever have been. Of course we accept your challenge! That just means, yet again, I get to hurt Scotty Swift! I get to break his neck!
See, the thing is, Damien, Scott, Omar, you're so concerned about Richard R. Russell, you're taking your eyes off the prize. The three men standing here right now is the three men you're dealing with at Battle of the Nations.
You're stepping into our world, our ring. A traditional six-man tag team wrestling match. We're perfect, but we made one mistake. At Aberdeen Anarchy, we left you crawling on your hands and knees when we should have left you in body bags. But it's okay. Battle the Nations, we're going to finish what we started. Forever the Foundation.
Before we get to the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship, that was a lot of content, video content of the kind of story we've got coming into this match. At Aberdeen Anarchy, Foundation of the Future defeated Sterling Oil. Sterling Oil, which is made up of William Sterling, Damien, and Scotty Swift, the returning Scotty Swift. Richard Russell was a massive factor in that. We played his apology. We've also played the reactions that have went out over the last few weeks on YouTube. So there's, as I said, there's a lot to digest there. Hopefully, go back, listen to it, go back and watch it, go into WrestleZone Scotland on YouTube, and you can watch them for yourself in higher quality. The Foundation of the Future, Zach Dynamite, Bruiser Brad Evans, and Ryan Riley are taking on the team of Scotty Swift, Omar Muhammad, and Damien. Now, this is a team, this is a match that I actually suggested around about Regal Rumble time. Sure, I think it was around about Regal Rumble time. It may have been before then. I think it was around about maybe Peterhead, possibly even Granite City Showdown back in January. It's a match I wanted to see. I wanted to see this because I wanted to see the kind of not even past, present, and future of WrestleZone take on the Foundation of the Future, but it's the foundations of WrestleZone and the new foundations that they're creating. You know, the Scotty Swift and Damien, they've been and seen and literally done. Just about done it all. I think both of them are. I think Damien's short a Regal Rumble and a Tri-Counties title win, and Scotty Swift is short a Tri-Counties title win. But even then, these two are the only guys that have won the original Triple Crown when it was the Wrestling Heavyweight title, the No Limits Championship, and the Tag Team Championship. So these guys have been there since pretty much day one. Certainly Scotty, probably Damien as well. They've been there since the first show. We've been there, done it all. I think Damien has been because he was tag team champion very early on in his WrestleZone career. So this, if we thought the Sterling Oil versus Foundation match with the bells and whistles of a no holds barred environment would be chaotic. I don't know who's going to be refereeing this match, whether it's Dennis, whether it's Mikey, whether it's one of the new kids they've got coming through the academy. They're going to have a lot of work to do to try and keep some sort of order. If anything, as much as my reservations about Dennis Law have been in the past, I'd probably put Dennis in here. Dennis seems like the coolest head to put in this kind of match, you know? Foundation of the Future, what can I say that I haven't already said about the Foundation of the Future? They are, said it themselves, and I can't willingly disagree when they say that they are the best three-man team in the country. It's very difficult for me to go, oh, but what about this team? What about that team? These guys have won tag team titles not only in WrestleZone, they've won them elsewhere. These guys have won titles collectively. They've won all the gold in WrestleZone. Collectively, they're a Grand Slam winner. Zach Dynamite is only a tag team title in WrestleZone short. That is it. Bruiser Brad and Ryan Riley are one of the best tag teams going. I mean, Ryan Riley and Zach Dynamite are a very formidable duo elsewhere down in Dundee and Angus. So they are an absolute cohesive trio. There's never been this kind of problem. There's never been. I don't think I've ever remembered a moment where these guys weren't a of unit once the Foundation of the Future was concepted and born. These guys have always been they've got each other's backs, they're cerebral, they're violent as a trio. And they proved that at Aberdeen Anarchy when they desecrated, they dismantled Sterling Oil. William Sterling pretty much his knee ripped out of its socket. We had Scotty Swift get Diamond clashed through a table that was sitting on ringside. I mean, he's only lucky that Brad slipped, because that was due to be a pile driver through a table. With Damien getting tied up and near handcuffed to a barrier and beaten. These guys are dangerous, you know? These guys are scary. And Zach Dynamite, Bruiser Brad Evans, and Ryan Riley, when they put the black and gold on and they enter through that curtain, they are a dangerous trio. They are a scary trio. Terrifying. And they come and they're being put into these six-man matches. They're not unbeatable. The outfit beat them last year. You know, they can be beaten, but that loss seems to have turned up the violent to 11. These guys don't have any respect for the foundation of WrestleZone, because they're looking to break it to build a foundation for the future. All of that being said, and getting very dramatic here, they're taking on Scotty Swift, Omar Mahadev, and Damien, who have a lot of issues right now. They do, because Scotty Swift and Damien, they've always kind of had a shaky ground of respect. But after the Sterling Oil debacle at Aberdeen Anarchy, that's in question. There's cracks forming there. Scotty Swift came back, and you'll have heard it, didn't tell Omar that he was returning. So even though, you know, outwardly they talk about a cohesion and being together and being this trio, they are not a cohesive unit like the Foundation of the Future. They're coming in here as the underdogs, which is, when you look at the accolades that Scotty and Damien have, certainly in WrestleZone, that's unbelievable. But they're coming in against the Foundation of the Future, who are an absolute terrifying force. They're a triforce of terror in the Northeast. I gave Sterling Miller a chance at Aberdeen Anarchy. I think there's going to have to be a miracle for Scotty Swift, Omar Mohammed, and Damien. And I say that hurts my heart saying that, because I'm a big fan of Omar. I love Scotty Swift and I love Damien. Hopefully we'll get him on the podcast one day and I can discuss it further. But we've had numerous chats with Scotty and numerous chats with Omar on this very channel. But unless something changes in the next few days, and there's no question mark over the thought processes of the outcome of Sterling Oil and the Richard R. Russell situation that is still looming as well, I don't give them a chance. They'll put on a fight. Absolutely, they'll put up a fight. They'll fight till their bitter end, bitter days. But six-man environment, I can't see this ending with a pinfall or a submission. It's either going to end with a knockout, or it's going to end no contest, and we're going to have to try and settle this further down the line, whether it's Halloween hijinks, which I'll be missing, so hopefully it's going to be Christmas chaos. Get the cage back out. I think we're going to need a way to contain all six of these wrestlers and get an outcome. It's not going to satisfy one team, but I think we need an outcome where we could put an end to this situation, where the Foundation are still tearing apart the foundations of WrestleZone, and this team, Scotty Swift, Damien, and Omar Mohammed, they're going to have a hell of a lot of work, not just as in this match, but also to try and repair the cracks that are starting to form in the foundations of WrestleZone. It's going to be exciting. It's going to be tense when it comes to it. But let's look at the main event. Final match here, Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. Let's have a look at it.
Hi wrestling fans, it's Mr. Partisan from WrestleZone Management, and I'd like to introduce to you my guest at this time, the Regal Rumble Trophy. Joking aside, we're using the Regal Rumble Trophy because what we've decided for Battle of the Nations on August 10th, the main event is going to be Caleb Valhalla defending his brand new WrestleZone Undisputed Championship. And he's going to be defending it against any number of the WrestleZone superstars whose names I have put in this cup. So right now, I'm quite simply going to put my hand in there, I'm going to pull out a name, and it's going to be one of the WrestleZone roster, and they're going to get a championship opportunity, main event at Battle of the Nations. So I'm as excited as my guest at this time. So here we go. Let's see who's going to be facing Caleb Valhalla. go. Facing Caleb Valhalla, August 10th, Battle of the Nations, Danestone Community Centre, for the undisputed championship will be Mickey Vago.
Ringers, we celebrate! Yes, the greatest victory in the mighty Caleb's time on the realm, no doubt. A great time for celebration. You were there in your hundreds to celebrate with the mighty Caleb. But there's also some thanks that the mighty Caleb has to give out. There's been many who've helped the mighty Caleb on his path to becoming the WrestleZone undisputed champion. And one of those men just so happens to be the mighty Caleb's next opponent, Mickey Vago. Well, Mickey, we've been through some stuff, haven't we? We've fought each other countless times. We've had many a beer. We've had a lot of good times. And I watched on as you took Lost Boy Aspen to his limit, just like the mighty Caleb did. And I watched as you got a rematch. It's strange. You could say the mighty Caleb had a point to prove. And you could say, I've done it. So thank you. Thank you, genuinely. I'm sure our battle will be great at Battle of the Nations. I'm sure we'll beat each other up just like we always do. And I'm sure afterwards we'll share a beer like we always do. Ha ha! But this time, you face the Jarl of WrestleZone. The undisputed champion. The mighty Caleb Valhalla. Skull! Skull! Skull.
And finally, the WrestleZone Undisputed WrestleZone Championship will be on the line when the new champion, Caleb Valhalla, takes on Mickey Vago, two of Montrose's own, well, Caleb, by way of New Asgard, taking on each other in this main event for the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. Mickey Vago coming off a win at Aberdeen Anarchy in that six-man tag that I mentioned already, coming in against Caleb Valhalla. These guys have had battles in the past over the Tri-Counties Championship. They've mostly in triple threat matches that they've tussled over the Tri-Counties title, which I think they kind of split wins. There's split wins in those triple threat matches, as far as I remember. I remember there was one at Inverurie that Caleb retained, and then there was a Halloween Hijinks one that I think it was 2022 that Mickey Vago retained the title at that point. So these guys have got a little bit of history with each other. It's always built on mutual respect, though. They've learned a lot about each other. They've teamed. They've learned. They've done some skateboarding and drinking, mostly drinking when it comes to it. I mean, they've hung out at skate parks and drank. Suddenly, I've made them 15. But Caleb Valhalla and Mickey Vago, they're gonna have a banger main event. It's one of those matches where you're coming out of Aberdeen Anarchy. There's a lot of question marks and stories, you know. And I think the one that's going to loom over this Undisputed Wrestling Championship, the match itself is going to be a very respectful contest, hard-hitting, but respectful contest. Don't get me wrong, Mickey Vago, if he's got Tommy Raiden with him, I have a trick or two up his sleeve. You know, Tommy Raiden's a bit of a wildcat, a bit of a chaotic force when he gets going. So, one to keep an eye on. The thing you've got to look out for is who's going to be sitting in the commentary desk. Because on that night, sitting at commentary and the rest, just checking, just for the whole night, as announced by WrestleZone, will be the former WrestleZone Undisputed Champion, Lost Boy Aspen. He'll be sitting out, he'll be at ringside with, presumably with James Chesser. He'll be sitting at ringside and watching the action. I don't know if that's something that's going to end up good or bad for either competitor, whether Caleb will be distracted by his Skull Brawl tag team partner being at ringside, or being, not ringside, being at the commentary desk, or as Mickey Vega will maybe be concerned that Osprey Aspen will be at the commentary desk. That's the question mark for this match. You know, two hard-hitting guys, no doubt about it. But that distraction, that I think that's going to ramp up a little bit more. These guys, not that they'll be looking to impress Lost by Aspen, because Aspen's sitting there as the former undisputed WrestleZone champion, the Grand Slam winner in WrestleZone, the first and at the moment only. But to have an audience of a potential challenger, a potential threat in the future, they're going to have to go a bit all out to show that they're not afraid of him. You know, they're not afraid to get down and dirty and just throw lumps at each other and batter each other within an inch of respectively their lives. I think that's so intriguing. So intriguing to me. And don't sit here and go, oh, because I'm a massive Aspen fan. I mean, that's a fact. But the fact that these two guys are going to be waging war over a title that he held so tight to until Aberdeen Anarchy, that's going to be a factor. You know, whether they know it or whether they're going to be concerned about it, whether Aspen is, that's kind of irrelevant to their own thoughts from me watching as a fan. I'm going to try and do that lizard thing where my eyes are going different directions, because I'll be trying, or that Shawn Michaels thing, but I'll be trying to watch Aspen at the commentary desk, and I'll be trying to watch the action. I want to see the reactions to the action, and there'll be a DVD I'm very interested to purchase in the near future. I'm hoping possibly we'll get a bit of highlights of the commentary as we go of the evening. But this match is very, very intriguing. Very intriguing for that reason, and for the match itself. I'm looking forward to seeing Caleb and Mickey Vago go at one-on-one. It's going to be just a hell of a main event. And you've heard me talk for a very long time about this show, and there's so many great matches, so many matches that I'm looking forward to from a logical story purpose in my mind, whether it's the in-ring action itself, with the possibility of future matches or outcomes because of it. But this match, I'm interested to see what's going to happen if Vago wins. If Vago wins, Caleb will be one of the shortest reigns as undisputed WrestleZone champion. If Valhalla wins, great. He's put another stamp in his reign. In his reign, his first stamp, his first scratch in the retention pot. The retention bedpost. He will do that, and then move forward to hijinks, to Stonehaven, to Inverurie, to Christmas Chaos, I'm sure. So this one. We talk about matches that have got intrigue because of the tournament aspect, because of title implications, because of the nature that may course correct everything in WrestleZone with that six man. But this is going to be the anchor. I don't talk about Captain Allen, but this is going to be the anchor of the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship being online. This is the top of the mountain. I've talked about anchors, which is the bottom. But the top of the mountain, Cale Valhalla taking on Mickey Vago. I'm excited. I want to see this. I'm looking forward to it. It's not going to be a pretty match by any stretch of the imagination. There's going to be a lot of hard hits, and there's going to be a lot of fists flying in this particular one. So, that's a nice little cool down for my excitement levels, because I'm really intrigued by this just wholeheartedly. And I can kind of have my brain starting to just calm down after all the madness that I've been talking for the last wee while. So, what a card. I'm looking forward to this. I've got my VIP ticket, so I'll be getting in at 6 p.m. to watch this show. If you haven't got your ticket yet, ringsideworld.co.uk. Let's look into the aftermath.
Okay, firstly, please forgive the lack of proper production values to this video, but I want to get this off my chest quickly and without having to wait for an official camera crew. See, my name has been being brought up in WrestleZone a fair few times lately, and I want to address that, because I think some of it's justifiable and some of it isn't. Firstly, regarding my explanation of my actions at Aberdeen Anarchy, people seem upset at me calling it a non-apology apology. And you know what? I have to bow to that and say you're correct. Damien, Scotty Swift, all of WrestleZone, you've got a point. I was trying to talk about a very personal, emotional situation and maybe I didn't get out everything that I wanted to get out. So for your benefit and for the benefit of anyone else who needs to hear it, for my actions at Aberdeen Anarchy, I apologise. I'm sorry. But I know that me saying those words and you hearing those words, it won't change anything. You're going to have it in your heads that something's still going on that isn't. Because that's the other way I hear my name being brought up, is in some sort of conspiracy concerning Richard R. Russell and the Foundation of the Future. Once again, I have no links to the Foundation of the Future. What happened to Aberdeen Anarchy in terms of what my actions had nothing to do with them. If I was Damien, if I was Scotty Swift, and if I was now Omar Muhammad, I'd be concentrating on the Foundation of the Future in a different way, because you gentlemen have signed up for a huge six-man tag team match Saturday, August the 10th at Danestone Community Centre. It's Battle of the Nations 2024. That's where my focus would be. And I don't know how to prove to you what I can do to show or say anything to make you understand I'm not involved anymore. You know what? Here's the thing. How about this? There are still some tickets left for Battle of the Nations. How about I finish recording this, I go and I log on to ringsideworld.co.uk and I pick up one of those last remaining tickets. And I find myself at Battle of the Nations purely as a spectator for the first time in my life. Maybe then you'll see me there. You'll see that I have nothing to do with any of you. Maybe then you'll believe me.
Welcome to the aftermath. I'm just stealing all the stuff from OSW Review, it seems, this evening, this afternoon. Tickets are still available, limited though, so if you haven't got your ticket, go to ringsideworld.co.uk, go get your ticket, go check out WrestleZone on all social media. Type in WrestleZone Scotland, you will likely find WrestleZone in Aberdeen, and you can find out more about that. One thing I did miss was in the six-man tag match, not only all that excitement and hyperventilating that I did, Richard R. Russell will be in the crowd. He will bought a ticket. He'll be sitting in the crowd watching this match, which, talk about tension. Talk about tension. That's going to be terrifying to think about. What if these guys will be amped up and just on edge as it is? The fact that six of them have now got to stand and fight each other with that question mark over Richard R. Russell. Yeah, that's a lot to take in. But this has been the WrestleZone Podcast. Like I said, I want to try and make these episodes like nice and compact, but I can't. I get too excited. I like talking about WrestleZone. I like talking about wrestling in general. So tickets are available, like I said, ringsideworld.co.uk. Doors open 6 p.m. for VIP, 6:30 for general. Bell time 6:15 approximately for VIP and 7 p.m. for general. We've got a Tri-Counties tournament beginning. We've got two title matches. We've got that massive six-man tag. There's so much going on here. Go get a ticket. Go to WrestleZone at Danestone Community Centre. You will love it. Trust me, there's no stairs. Everything's on flat ground, which, you know, is a bonus. It's a nice venue. Limited parking though, so if you want to get, if you're taking your car, maybe get there a bit early, but take public transport. I think bus stop, like, they're right outside the venue. So yeah, go check out your travel links, get to the show, go sell it out. Let's sell out Danestone Community Centre and go watch some WrestleZone. It's Battle of Nations time, and I'll come back to Battle Bowl of Nations in a future, maybe in the recap, possibly we'll come back to that. But in the meantime, this has been the WrestleZone Podcast. I have been Billy, your WrestleZone super fan. I'm looking forward to seeing you there on August 10th. Say hello. You know, I do have a bulldog chewing a wasp look. That's just my general face and demeanor. But say hello. I will say hello back. Have a good time. See you Saturday.